In this video, I will show you exactly how I managed to unlock the front lever and how you can do it faster, providing some effective exercises and tips. Comment down below where you are in your front lever journey and how long it took you to get there. So a few days ago, I got my very first front lever hold since I started with calisthenics, and I started to specifically train for it a little less than a year ago. So it took me about a year to unlock it. But I think you can do it way faster because I made two big mistakes which slowed down my progress. And this happened 3 times during my front lever journey. The first mistake was that I avoided dynamic exercises and I stuck to the isometric holds and the negatives only. I never really focused on the concentric part, and at first this was fine. But then I tried to work towards a straddle front lever. 2 or 3 months passed and I still couldn't do it, and I even felt weaker sometimes. These exercises were thus not enough, so I decided to incorporate more dynamic exercises. This changed everything and helped me to unlock the straddle front lever and even the full front lever. I will now show you exactly what steps to take in order to unlock this insane exercise. Before you start, I would recommend you to build a good foundation of strength first. This is to avoid injuries, but also, if you don't have solid foundation yet, progressing towards harder variations will take forever. So I would recommend you to be at least able to do pull-ups, inverted deadlifts and skin the cats before you start your front lever journey. These exercises will build your straight arm, upper back, your lats, abs and lower back strength. These are the main elements used in the front lever. The very first progression of the front lever is a tuck front lever hold. The goal is to increase your hold time to get a higher volume of front lever training. If you are used to skin the cats and upside down deadlifts, unlocking the tucked version should not take you too long. The most important thing is to keep your arms straight and to lean back. Because of gravity, your shoulder blades will be in a protracted position, and to really activate your lats, it is important to keep your shoulder blades in a neutral position. So in order to do this, counter this protraction by retracting your shoulder blades so they stay in a neutral position. The second progression is the advanced tuck front lever hold, where you open up your hips and extend your knees. This will require more lat strength, core engagement, glute activation and understanding of the movement. To unlock this exercise, I used advanced tuck negatives, assisted advanced tucks and tuck front lever holds. But I would also recommend you to keep working on your skin the cats and upside down deadlifts. The next step will be a lot harder. It is now time to extend one leg, and now using dynamics will be very effective in combination with isometrics and negatives. So for this I also use single leg negatives, assisted holds, and I get working on my advanced tuck holds. But I would have got it way faster if I also used dynamics. The dynamic exercises I recommend are the single leg front lever raise, just attempt to get as high as possible without breaking form, and advanced tuck front lever raises. Try to go all the way up and all the way down. Maybe even hold the middle part for a second. When you look for front lever tutorials, you often see a lot of variations like the half lay, the straddle half lay with single leg, etc. And though these might be very effective, I never really liked these variations. For me, it felt kind of uncomfortable and hard to understand these moves, so I used the same variations I also used in my back lever journey. Therefore, the next exercise is a straddle front lever. This step is way harder than the single leg front lever and could take a little more time, but already working on this will boost your front lever strength tenfold, even though you can't hold it yet. Because you force your body to adapt to this harder variation, you will do the easier ones more effortlessly. Working on my straddle front lever helped me mastering the single leg front lever raise by providing me more strength, and after, I was able to raise my body up all the way towards the bar, and being able to do this will boost your straddle front lever. So for the straddle version, I mainly use straddle negatives, straddle raises attempts, assisted straddle holds, and I also use single leg raises and advanced tuck holds and raises. The same approach worked for me with unlocking the full front lever hold. I didn't expect this, but the full front lever felt so much harder than the straddle variations. But after unlocking the straddle, I still worked on the full front lever. Again, this boosted my straddle hold time, my straddle front lever raise, and all the previous progressions. And all these exercises again boosted my full front lever. So I unlocked the full front lever with the same exercises, by mainly working on negatives, front lever raise attempts, assisted front lever holds, straddle raises and single leg raises. I also used the other previous exercises, but I switched it up. So every workout I did 1 or 2 of the other previous exercises, like advanced holds or tuck holds. And each workout I would pick different exercises. So this is how I approach my font lever journey and how I build insane font lever strength. And I will keep using this to further improve this strength. As mentioned before, one mistake was using dynamics way too late in my font lever journey. But I haven't mentioned the second one yet. The second big mistake was that I used too many exercises and too many sets for each workout. After a while, this made me feel like I was losing progress instead of gaining it. I had workouts for other skills as well, and this combination even got me injured. This really slowed down my front lever progress a few times. I will make a more detailed video about these mistakes. Also, if you need help with something or you want me to make a certain video, please let me know in the comment section. A quick bonus tip, you can use Dragonflex as well to supplement your front lever. This will reduce the lat strength needed so you can really focus on the core element of the front lever. If this video was useful for you, please let me know and like and subscribe to support the channel. I wish you all good luck and I hope to see you in the next video.